Our next question is, why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam have so many wives? And for this question, I'll pass it to Ustada Noura.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. This is a good question, and it's one that reoccurs periodically. But the answer is actually quite simple and straightforward, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Of course, we know that our Prophet, peace be upon him, was protected from doing anything that was disagreeable or disliked or in any way disapproved of by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we know that everything in the practice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is good, and everything that he showed us is the right way, and that we also know that he had to do certain things as a prophet that did not apply to other people. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had more requirements, for example, than the rest of us did. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would fast continuously, and when his Sahaba asked him about it, he told them that he was fed and given drink by Allah, and in a way that they were not, and so they could not follow that sunnah of his. But at the same time, much of the life of the Prophet ﷺ is there for us to learn and to see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes for us to act. Now, one of the most critical parts of a human being's life is their intimate family life. And in order for this sunnah of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and for the rulings connected to these aspects to be transmitted, the Prophet, peace be upon him, had to have a number of wives. Now, someone might say, well, what if, you know, it would have been sufficient for him simply to have married. However, as we know, the human being is always looking for excuses. So if he had only had one wife, we might have had a lot of people saying, well, it was just because she was this way, or because it was that way, or, well, she was special. But when we see that the Prophet ﷺ had multiple wives from very different ages, there were some that were young, some were middle-aged, some were quite old, some were older than him when he married them. He, sallallahu alayhi wa, married people from very different backgrounds, from very high and lofty lineage, and from very noble clans. He married people who were non-Arabs. He married people from various different backgrounds. He married widows, he married people who had been divorced, and he married Sayyidina Aisha, for example, who was the only wife who had not been married before. And so in all of these different stages of life and experiences, we see then what are the rulings that apply to women in these circumstances. We also see the Prophet ﷺ married women who had children. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was a stepfather. So we see how he deals with the children who came into his household from another marriage. So by having multiple wives, we see the full fleshing out, the full unfolding of the sunnah of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and the addressing of all the different possible circumstances that a person could be in, both as a husband and a wife. And so this is one of the major reasons the scholars have identified, and it is very clear for why the Prophet ﷺ had multiple wives. And if you look at each one of them, they are basically a prototype, if you will, if I can use that term, for women from different backgrounds. So Sayyidah Khadija was older than him. She had been married before. She had children. Some of the other wives had been divorced. Some of them, other wives were widowed. Some of them were, Sayyidah Aisha had never been married. He married people from different tribes, as we said, and different clans. The other benefit was, as a political leader, the Prophet ﷺ in these marriages brought many of these tribes and many of these clans into the fold of Islam. It was a way of drawing their hearts and building a relationship with these other nations and other tribes and so on. Additionally, not just the initial political link, but also now these clans and these tribes had a person who came from their same background, their same experience, from whom to learn the sunnah of the Prophet, peace be upon him. So, just in short, we can see that these are some of the reasons why the Prophet, peace be upon him, married multiple wives. And any allusion by any of the enemies of Islam that the Prophet ﷺ married for any other reason, that he married, just don't have any basis in fact. Almost all of his marriages took place after he was he had passed the age of 50. He was not, his business was not relations with people, with women. His purpose was to establish the hukum, the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to show people the best way to be in all the different various life stages and experiences. So inshallah ta'ala, that inshallah answers that question in brief. And if anybody would like more information, there are some very good articles out there, inshallah ta'ala. Ustaz Fathullah Gulan, a Turkish scholar, has a very good article on this subject, if anybody would like to read it in more depth, inshallah ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.